to HitchcockMovies.com. We are your hosts, Jeff and Diane, and this is movie number 27 from 1946, Notorious, starring Cary Grant and Ingrid Bergman. Well, we've got good news. Actually, I've got good news and really good news. The good news is we get to watch Notorious tonight, and the really good news is this is not a David O. Selznick production. We're actually nearing the end of the 7-year deal that brought Alfred Hitchcock from England to Hollywood in 1939, 7 plus 9, it's coming up. And, in fact, next week's movie, Paradine Case, is the last one. That is the Selznick production, and that's it. That's the last one. And to no one's surprise, they didn't sign a new deal together, although Selznick certainly tried. He wanted to, and because Hitchcock was making them so much money, but because of all the meddling we've gotten into it with the other movies, Hitchcock just wanted nothing to do with it. So what we do have tonight is the second Hitchcock Ingrid Bergman Ben Hecht collaboration, the second of two. Last week's Spellbound was the first one, and which where Selznick did meddle with it. This actually started off as a Selznick picture. It's just that he sold it off, and we'll get into that in a second. Selznick had this story idea. He had lots of story ideas, and he passed it on to Alfred Hitchcock. It was from a two-part short story published in the Saturday Evening Post in 1921 called The Song of the Dragon by John Tainterfoot. And he passed it on to Hitchcock and Ben Hecht. Selznick wanted to do it. He wanted Joseph Cotten to be in it because Joseph Cotten was cheaper. Both Hitchcock and Ben Hecht loved the basic idea, and they set about writing it. The original story was sort of a World War I era thing, so they updated it to make it about Nazis hiding out in South America, specifically Brazil. And that sounds like Hitchcock, and basically wrote the story from scratch. We talked a lot about Ben Hecht last week, so we don't have to talk about him today. But if you've not done your Ben Hecht, just read up about him on Wikipedia. It's quite worthwhile. So I mentioned Selznick selling this off. Well, he lost interest in this project because, well, among other things, he thought the plot was dumb. He didn't really get it, and that's fine because he sold it off to RKO Pictures for a lot of money and a percentage of the profits, this guy. And so basically, once they started working on it, Selznick had nothing to do with it, which is, as we've seen before, a very good thing for us. Now, why did he sell it off? Well, David O. Selznick had his own problems at the time. He was busy producing the Western epic film called Duel in the Sun, which we've seen, and he was losing lots of money on it. It was way over budget, and he needed the cash, simple as that. So he raised the cash by selling Notorious. A little tidbit about David O. Selznick. He loved the success that he had. He was driven to equal the success, or perhaps surpass the success, of Gone with the Wind, because he didn't want the headlines when he died to say, David O. Selznick, producer of Gone with the Wind, died today, which of course is exactly what happened. He couldn't rest. He really wanted to not be. It's hardly a one-hit wonder, but he was working on Duel in the Sun, and although worth seeing, it's got Gregory Peck in it, who we saw last week, and Joseph Cotten in it, who was our excellent bad guy in Shadow of a Doubt. It's worth seeing, but. Hitchcock and Hecht were left alone to do their thing, which is great, and RKO leaves them alone. No one comes down to meddles. The only meddling they had to deal with was basically the censors, and we'll talk about that in a bit. So we already know who's in this one: Ingrid Bergman and Cary Grant. It has to be pointed out that these two were such huge stars, and at this moment in time, they are at the height of their career. So this is a big deal. You read up on Wikipedia on Ingrid Bergman, it mentions this movie and Casablanca. Cary Grant, it mentions a bunch of movies, but it mentions all the Hitchcock movies, but it mentions this one. This was a big one. Thirdly, the other person in it is Claude Rains. And if you don't know Claude Rains, he was huge character in the movie Casablanca, Louis Renault, excellent character. He's good. He's so good in everything. We've seen him a lot in some of the movies we've been watching along the years, and we just love the guy. He was Claude Rains was nominated for Best Supporting Actor 4 times in his career. It ought to have been more. It's tragic that he never won. It's interesting pointing out that Cary Grant never won. He was nominated 2 times for Best Actor and he never won. That's scandalous for both of them. So, speaking of the censors, Ben Hecht and Alfred Hitchcock, in writing this from scratch, they wanted at the beginning, Ingrid Bergman's character was to be a prostitute, and that wasn't going to fly. So you know, if you're looking at her character, think, you know, that's what they were thinking. And you know, the word notorious, it doesn't really have the meaning today of what it did in you know, certainly in that time. Notorious is referring to a criminal or what have you, but when it referred to a woman, certainly in the 40s and probably 30s and 20s, it sort of meant that a woman who, you know, drank and spent time in the company of men and had loose morals, it wasn't good. So it was pretty much the worst thing you could call a woman. Wasn't nice. And also with the censors, with regards to the production code, they had lots and lots of rules about what you couldn't do. And I mean, you had to submit your film to them. And if they saw something in it they didn't like, they wouldn't give you a rating and you couldn't release your movie in every city. Well, one of the rules they had was a kiss on the lips could only last, it's 3 seconds, could only last 3 seconds. So look for that in this movie, because it wouldn't surprise us to see Alfred Hitchcock get around that. So very good. So speaking of Alfred Hitchcock, yep, there's a cameo in this one. I almost forgot to mention it, but you know, you'll see it. And look for some great camera work and some great direction. It's not distracting, but you know, if you've watched all these movies up to this point, you know, tonight might be your big reward for we get to watch Notorious. So I talked about the music a lot in last movie Spellbound. Not going to say a word about it, and you'll see why as we watch this film. So good. So let's get to it. This great movie from 1946. 1946, World War II is over, but the Cold War is just beginning. So with that, from 1946, Notorious. Let's watch.